Hey, what's up guys? Today's video we will talk about a deck which is in my opinion a huge problem in Clash Royale. Golem, Clone, really matchup dependent deck. So we're going to jump into some games and I will show you matchups where I will win easily and where I can't do anything. And this is not the best deck in Clash Royale, just to let you know. This is not the best deck in Clash Royale, but if you want to push some easy trophies, want to troll your friends, this is the deck you want to play. And let me know in the comments if you think this deck should be playable or not, because I feel like there are matchups where your opponent doesn't really have any chance. I think it's so frustrating to lose against Golem first play. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to use creator code MonoShop. With all your support, I might be able to open this legendary chest in few months. So thank you so much for all the support. Just joking, guys. Let's jump to the games. Let's go, guys. So, guys, here in the first game against Mokri. And let's see what Mokri is playing here. We just go for Skull Army Bridge. Golem first, but it's actually the best move. But unfortunately, we don't have enhanced. So we see a Zap. We're just going to Bats here. I don't really want to play. Yeah, okay. Here's a Firecracker, which is good against Golem. Yes. But at the same time, against Clone, we have the arrows. That's why we have the arrows in our deck. So, honestly, as long as he doesn't have Rocket, we should have a 1-0 matchup. And this is the great thing about deck. Yes, sometimes, okay, as Inferno Drain, didn't expect it. But sometimes, you can't do anything with this deck if your opponent is Poison. But the nice thing is, not a ton of people are using Poison currently. And that basically means against any Fireball deck, you most of the time have the matchup advantage. So we go for Golem in the back. And let's see, what is he able to do? He doesn't have his Hawk Rider. Yes, he does have the... So we're just gonna Skarmy that. If he's gonna zap this, we have to. If he's gonna zap that, we have to bats. And so he's gonna zap this, yes, but it's not even gonna be tower down. Look at the elixir he spent there. He spent the Mega Knight, the Goblin Gang, and the Zap, which is 10 elixir. And you can't really spend 10 elixir and defend the Golem Knight, which push alone. This is not he's not able to do that. So we go with bats here. And as long as we are having a bit of luck here, he's like at 0 elixir currently. And we're gonna get a huge clone out of that. And he doesn't have something like a poison now. Or like, I don't really think he can defend that. GG's well played. Free crown win. The Megan is just dying. This is a great game to start off today's video. GG's well played. Nothing to do for him. He can't do anything. This deck is simply broken. If you get a... Like, it's so frustrating to play against if you don't have the right cards, right? And he didn't. Here we go. Next game. Firestone. Good luck, my friend. And we don't have Golem starting end. Once again, this is unfortunate. And by the way, thanks for all the feedback on the last video. I'm on the card ranking. I wasn't able to read my comments yet. But even... Yeah, I'm not always... I'm trying to read the comments always. But you guys... I think you guys understand that I have like some ton of time... that I'm really busy right now. And I don't have a ton of time to read every comment, like every video. Especially right now because of CL going on, so many like preparation stuff. So I hope you guys understand that I'm not able to respond any comment currently. But I hope you guys also know that I appreciate any comment you do because, yeah. Doesn't matter what you comment. Okay, if you hate me for no reason, it's not that nice. But I know if you guys are saying like you love the video or you're going to do suggestions, I always appreciate and I will try to read them afterwards. So, yeah, thank you so much for all the support. So, I would say, we go with bats. Let's go with bats. Go for Nightwitch here. Normally, you want to play Nightwitch far in the back if you get more bats. But I don't really want my Golem to die. Lumberjack. What's he gonna do now? Okay, Lumberjack is... Yeah, we got a Golem clone push off here. This is gonna be tower down. There's no way for him to defend this. And also, okay, great Electus Whipband, but this is going to be another really good matchup for us because it doesn't really have anything against the Skarmy besides the Electus Bird, and even the Electus Bird is not killing the full Skarmy. So I don't really see any way he's going to win this game. This is going to be another win against Fireball decks. As I said, it's going to be such a good game matchup. And this deck makes a ton of fun. It's like really great to push up if you're like not really, if you're feeling you didn't play for a long time. And after the reset, you're not really high, you want to push trophies fast. This is the deck you want to play. This is insane. So... I would even say we go for bats and we go for Nightwitch to the right. We want to play it a bit far in the back. As I said, to get more bats out of that. And we go for Beodrink exactly like this. Of course, yeah, it's doing a great job. And the one bat is actually killing a ton of stuff. So. We go for it. Honestly, the Zappies even helped me. Because of the Zappies, I was able to get a better. Clone because the Golem got stunned. And yeah, he needs to go for another Goblin Cage here. And yeah, the Flying Machine is just not good enough, I would say. It's not good enough. So because we can go now with Lumba, we just arrow that, and the arrows are gonna be able to kill the flying machine. The Horgy's GG's well played, nothing he can do. Once again, easy victory. I feel so bad for my opponents, they're sweating the lies. They just wanna push a bit up. And I'm playing like a no-brain deck. GG's well played, I apologize, my man. And I hope you're still using Creator Code Morton. Gonna see you guys in the next game. Let's go. Here we go, next game, Rainbow. Oh, I don't care, we're just doing gold in first play. We don't have a Night Witch, but I'm like really confident right now after two wins. I don't really care, let's go. He spells Scaly Drank, so perfect start for us. We're just gonna let it go. Man, what is this for a push? Come on, dude, we have a Golem on the field. What's this for a punishment? After Scaly Drank's nerf, there's not gonna be a ton of damage. Scaly Drank's not really good in offense anymore, but still great in defense, so don't put him off deck, out of your deck. Okay, I would say we're gonna clone this. I don't really think he has enough elixir for tornado yet. That's why I'm doing that.
You are 100% wrong.
Okay, now he has enough elixir. I was wrong. I hate to be wrong, but I was wrong. But the golemites are still chipping away. We're gonna be like even in damage, I think. Like even. But at least we have another golem in hand, so I think the arrows were still fine. I think we are up by elixir at least. Oh, you hate to see it. You hate to see Pump. You hate to see Pump. Pump is not what you want to see. Okay, at least we can build up a huge golem push. We should get his tower here. Ice with NATO, Pump with E-Drag. Oh no, this is a tough matchup. Actually, this deck finished really high last season. I think Jonah got like top 10 with it, but until at the end. But so, this is not even... that's not just a meme deck. That's tough. We're just gonna arrow that. Great arrows. He's gonna go with another pump most likely. I hope we're still at least even from elixir. Okay, pump. How are we gonna punish the pump? Golem. He can golem himself. I mean, we need to do split lane pressure, right? Like, I can't really... Okay. Let's go. Baby D. Behind the golem. He's another E-Drag, man, that's crazy. That's so crazy, no! Arrows. What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do, guys? How am I supposed to defend this? If I win this game, man, if he's like up by 10,000 elixir. Golem. That's... Oh no, this is so bad. Look at my golem. Yeah, which golem? That's the question. Like, I'm asking it myself as well. Yeah. No, that's unlucky. Did the dragon survive with 0 HP? Maybe deserved. GG's well played. Can't do anything. Golem pump. Actually, really tough matchup, but still. It kind of proves the point I am kind of making this video. Yes, there are impossible matchups, but if you lose against it, it's always so frustrating because you never feel like, yeah, the opponent played better than me, right? That's the point of the video. I couldn't really do anything. I still think I played well with Golem Clone overall. GG's well played. It's fine. I can't really blame anyone. If you play the deck, you deserve to lose, right? GG's well played. See you in the next one. Let's go. Here we go. Next game against Lucky Boy. Good luck. Last time Golem Clone didn't work. Let's try it again, guys. So Golem in the back. Yeah, once again, Ice Wiz. Okay. You're not being lucky today. Back when I played offline, I faced all of the Recruits decks. All of the Recruits, Fireball Bay decks and Lock Bay. These are like easy matchups. But let's see, go for Bay Udang High. That's He actually thought he had Gray, but he has E-Giant. E-Giant is so bad for me. E-Giant, Tornado against Clone? Come on! I could do also a deck about, also a video about his deck. His deck is kind of on the same level as mine. I hate E-Giant. What do you guys think about E-Giant? Okay, it's Golem. He's gonna do this, so we're gonna Golem also in the back. Can we still win this game? I mean, his lightning wasn't good. I don't really agree with his lightning there. Like his first one. Okay, Baby Dragon. Problem is he has Cage and we don't have a building. Actually a big problem. Yeah, it would be cool if the Baby Dragon stays out of tower range. Okay. Let's see. Oh man, we're getting karma for this, for playing this deck. Golem Bridge. Need to go Golem Bridge here. Skarmy. Clone. I really think we should get this tower here. We do. Come back. Okay, Baby Dragon like this, but he can Golem in a pocket. We have a huge problem. Not like Golem at the bridge. Which could seal the deal. Nado. From him, yeah. Baby Dragon, yes. Okay, we are still in, man. Intense game. Even we're playing both not the highest skill decks in the game. I think we're both putting up a great fight for you guys. So, okay, Baby Dragon should get one ship hit. No, it's not. Okay, doing this. Nado, arrows. Okay. That's a problem. He has so many answers. Look at this. Supposed to win this one. Oh, so damn. Okay. Clone. I tried my best, guys! We got the biggest count in the game! GG's well played. I'm still gonna upload it. I'm still thinking, even we lost two games, I still think it was a great video. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Let me know you guys like this one if I lose, because I don't really think this is today a deck where I'm like not saying this is the best deck in Clash Royale. So if you guys are looking for the best deck in Clash Royale, I did like better videos on like decks in general. This is more like a showing a deck which I think shouldn't exist in Clash Royale. And I think the two wins and two losses got the point. They're like two matchups. I can't do anything. It's 100-0 for the opponent. Like, how am I supposed to win? But they're also matchups. Like, look at this two. impossible for the opponents to win. It's like 1-0 for me. This is like the problem for me with this deck. You can't really outplay anyone. If the opponent has Tornado, it's over. If your opponent doesn't have Tornado or Poison, it's over for you. So let me know in the comment section, you think this deck should be in the game. It's kind of the, it's like in a card game, it should exist. Or you guys are saying, no, this deck is a problem for the game in general. Really excited for your comments there and really excited for your opinion. And I would say, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to use Critical Mode. I'm out. Peace out. Thanks for watching and goodbye, guys.